Greetings, MechWarriors. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is TTB speaking. And as you all know, there is currently another event going on combined with a sale on Hero Mechs, both Inner Sphere and Clan Heroes. And you guys have asked me to make a video about which mechs I think are worth buying, both on the Inner Sphere side as well as on the Clan side. So this is going to be the Inner Sphere mech buy recommendations for Hero Mechs. Let's dive right into it. And this is it's quite a big sale. I mean, as you can see, there's three pages full of mechs here. And we're not going to look at them this way, though. We're going to look at them through the normal mech store, because then we can just divide it up by weight classes, and that's going to be a much easier time for us. Now, in the light mech department, which mechs would I personally recommend? And caveat, guys, these are my own personal recommendations based on which mechs I like a lot or which mechs I have found to be the best to play for myself. You might have a different opinion. If you have a different opinion, or if you feel I forgot one mech that you like, just put it down in the comments. But for me, in the light mech department, I think the mechs we need to talk about are the Wolfhound Grinner. Really, really solid light mech. Comes with ECM and good armor values. For example, 5 medium pulses are built really, really good on this one. Then, of course, the urban mech, the K9, the only mech that has a siren and blinking police lights you can turn on and off. This one also works very well with 5 medium pulses, and being an urban mech, it is just an insanely tanky light mech, so that is definitely a recommendation of mine. And then also, I would say, if you're looking to go into fast light mechs, scouting type light mechs, you can think about the Pirate's Bane. I mean, it's only 750 MC. You can just do medium lasers or small lasers and Guardian ECM. It's gonna be solid, but bear in mind, guys, you are going to be piloting a 20 tonner with basically no armor, so this thing dies very, very fast, but can be fun as well. Okay, so much for the light mechs. You could also think about a Commando Death Snell, for example. Works quite nicely with 4 medium pulses. I made a video about that recently. Also fun to play, and has surprising tanking capability for its size. I think these are all the light mechs I want to talk about for the Inner Sphere. Let's have a look into medium mechs. So the medium mechs are a little bit more difficult for me, because honestly, there are none that I would recommend as being especially insanely good. However, there are some that are interesting and that I like to play. The Blackjack Arrow is one of those. You can play it, for example, with pulse lasers and machine guns, 6 machine guns. Quite nice to play. The Assassin Dark Death is an assassin that has ECM but has very weird weapon groups, so you gotta get a little bit creative with that if you want to make that work. Then there is, of course, the Bushwhacker High Roller. You can do a triple rack 2 build, for example, or a double rack 5 build. But you can do that on the normal mechs as well, so there's not that much reason to buy one of those. The Yenlo Wang isn't bad. You got your 2 energy weapons, and then probably combined with an AC-20 to make use of the AC-20 cooldown and ballistic cooldown. So that's not a bad mech to play. Then there's the Enforcer Ghillie. That's the Enforcer that has ECM, actually, and some ballistics cooldown as well. So this one makes for a nice Gauss Rifle plus Laser Boat. Works not too bad. You could also look at things like the, where is it, Kintaro Golden Boy. Just looks nice, but as far as the mech itself goes, the Kintaro 18 is very comparable to that one, so I don't know whether you would want to buy that or not just because of that. The Shadowhawk Hero mech, the Grey Death, again, in my opinion, nothing sets it so much apart that it is a definite buy for me. Trebuchet Loup de Guerre is interesting to me just due to the missile velocity, the cooldown quirks, as well as the SRM-6 heat generation, so that could be a nice brawler, especially with the 4 hard points. So that's definitely an interesting one. And then other than that, I would say, yeah, there's really not much that would be extremely interesting to me in the medium mech division. In my opinion, it just lacks for the Inner Sphere at least, it just lacks the options that you have in the light mech department, where there are a clear set of really, really good mechs that you should definitely think about. Alright guys, now we are in the heavy mech department, and there are a few interesting mechs here. For example, the Archer Tempest is interesting. You can run that with ECM and MRMs to really great effect, so that's a nice heavy mech that you can pick up, especially with MRMs. This thing turns out to be quite the damage dealer. I like to use that a lot. Other than that, there are some interesting variants here of other mechs like the Black Knight or the Cataphract, but if you're looking for performance and if you're looking for mechs that just stand out to me for being able to do some good damage and they, I just enjoy to play, the Marauder Bounty Hunter 2 is definitely a candidate here, just for the fact that you got jump jets, you've got 7 energy weapons on this thing and a ballistic slot, so you can do like heavy gauss and 6 medium lasers, for example, on this build quite nicely, and it's a really, really, really fun build to play. So the Bounty Hunter 2, if you like Marauders, this is definitely worth picking up. Then on the Orion parts, the Orion Protector, I've had a lot of fun with this mech in particular. It's really nice for Gauss Rifle or AC-20 plus either SRMs or MRMs. I think with this one I would recommend maybe LB-20 and MRM-40. That should work quite nicely and has a nice skin. I enjoyed the Protector quite a bit. Then if you're only buying one Inner Sphere heavy mech, guys, then you want to get the IV-4. This thing is the most quirked mech that I've ever seen. With MRMs, this thing just turns into a menace. I've recently made a video about the build with 2 MRM-40s. I mean, just look at the quirks, guys. You've got 20% missile cooldown. 20%. 1/5 faster firing. It is just insane, guys. Like, the IV-4, definitely a must-buy. Really, really good mech overall, and you're gonna have a lot of fun with that. Then what's also interesting to me is the Roughneck Powerhouse. This is a really, really nice brawler. You've got the high mount up here and then your missiles on the side torso and in the CT. So you can turn this into a nice AC-20 and 3 SRM-6 brawler. I like to run this quite often and it's quite agile. It's a lot of fun to play. It has high hard points. I would definitely recommend picking that one up. The Thanatos Hangover can be interesting if you like to use combinations like streaks plus lasers, or if you want to run it in a rocket launcher configuration, you can do that as well, but that's just not my thing. Be aware, you have to put all of these into the, you have to put all of these into the right arm, so you are a little bit limited in terms of space what you can fit in there, but it has a nice right hook, that is for sure. And then also interesting to me is the Thunderbolt. Right here, that is the top dog, and the top dog comes equipped with, come on, stop scrolling for crying out loud, 9 energy hard points, so you can make really, really nice laser bolts here, and all the lasers except that one arm laser are quite nicely concentrated right here in the CT area, right below the cockpit or right on cockpit height, so you have a good grouping of your weapons together, so that's a lot of fun to play. Maybe something with large lasers and medium lasers or pulses and the mediums. You can do a lot of things with that. Definitely a fun mech to play. And then last but not least, definitely not least, the Warhammer Black Widow. And that is the only Warhammer that can run 4 ballistic weapons, and you can do like for something like AC-5s, UAC-5s, you can do insane 3-RAC-2 combination with XL engine that's very fast but also very damaging. And since the weapons are grouped very close to the cockpit and very close to the center of your mech, you're gonna have a lot of fun with that as well. So Black Widow, also a very interesting heavy mech. Alrighty guys, and here we finally are in TTB territory. The Assault mechs, my recommendations for Inner Sphere Assault Hero mechs. Annihilator, a mean baby. If you like missiles, get that one. You can do brawler builds with lasers and SRMs, you could do lasers and streaks, you could do MRM-120, you could do Dr. Lermenstein. There's so many things you can do with this mech. It's definitely a really, really nice hero mech. I enjoy this one a lot. Let's have a look at the Atlas. Now, with the Atlas, there's the Kraken and there's the Boar's Head. The Boar's Head, guys, is a trap. It is the one of the only, if not the only, Atlas that has structure instead of armor, which is bad shit stupid. And I have no idea why PGI chose to make it that way, but long story short, don't buy this one. This was the first hero mech I think they released. It's a lemon. Yes, you can make it work with 6 large pulse lasers, for example, and have like an insanely fast Atlas, but whatever. No. Just don't buy it. If you're gonna buy a hero mech, maybe buy the Kraken. A, it has armor instead of structure. And you can do something like a heavy gauss plus MRM-40 plus 5 medium lasers or something on that. So if you're gonna buy an Atlas hero, I would go for the Kraken over the Boar's Head. Awesome, not interesting. Banshee, well, you could get the Lamblelynch, which is quite a lemon if you guys don't have it already from the event a few weeks ago. The Siren is interesting, but also I wouldn't recommend them. These are not very strong mechs. Same goes for the Battlemaster Hellslinger, also not a very strong mech. The Charger and Seven, nah, I would not go for that either. What I would recommend to you guys though, definitely get this one. This is easily one of the strongest assault mechs out there. Cyclops, Sleipnir, Odin's Horse. So good. UAK-5, UAK-10s, UAK-5s, heavy Gauss rifles, RAK-2s and UAK-10s. There's so many builds you can do with this thing. I cannot oversell this. This is one of the most versatile Dakka mechs in the Inner Sphere you can find. It has great agility. Get that one. If you're only getting one mech here, probably go for the Sleipnir. Well, what else do we have? We've got the Fafnir, the Wrath. First and foremost, guys, this is one of the prettiest mechs I've ever seen. It is oh so shiny. Oh, so shiny. Really nice assault mech. Also comes with ECM. You can do nice brawler builds on this with AC20, and you could, for example, do it with SRMs, or yeah, you can just slap MRM120 onto this bad boy, for example, with triple 40s. So there's a lot of things you can do with this one. Fafnir Wrath, definitely a good choice if you like the Fafnir chassis. Hatamotoshi, same thing. The Shugo, I don't think if I would recommend that. Highlander Hero Mechs. The Heavy Metal has a very unique warhorn that's built into the mech, and that is the one thing that really sets it apart. Nobody else has that warhorn. You can only get that sound if you play this mech, the Heavy Metal. You can run it with, let's say, Gauss and then MRMs and whatnot. It's not a bad mech. It actually has a lot of armor for its size. I mean, if you look at this thing. You can get quite a bit of armor onto this bad boy, and for its 90 tons, it is surprisingly agile. But yeah, it's like one of these like oddities that can be fun to play, but is definitely not very high up on the food chain. The King Crab Kaiju. Yeah, I would also say this is an interesting mech. You can do, for example, heavy Gauss and six energy weapons, like for example, three LPLs and three medium lasers. You could do two LB20s and MRMs. There's a lot of options that you can do with this. Definitely an interesting mech, and the hard points are nice and high. However, there are some issues with convergence. So, definitely not a bad buy, but not the best in here, I would say. Then, let's have a look at the Mauler Hero mech here, the Knockout. Interesting, yes, but if you want to get a Mauler, I would recommend the first Mauler to get is the MX90, because that is definitely the most versatile, and that's not a Hero mech. The Nightstar Hero Mech here, the Wolf Phoenix. I generally don't recommend Nightstars because they're an odd bunch, but the Wolf Phoenix is a good one. You can go for a Stricken Energy build, or you do just MRM120 on this one, and you will be golden. It's a nice mech to play, and people underestimate the Wolf Phoenix quite a bit. Then the Stalker Hero Mech, the Misery. It's one of these mechs where you have to go for a mixed build with MRM, for example, and then ballistic and then lasers. It's a little bit of an odd one. Looks nice though, but not extremely high on my recommendations list. Same thing goes for the Victor Dragon Slayer or the Skokomish. The Skokomish is, in my opinion, guys, a fun mech because you can make this thing go extremely fast. We're talking over 100 kph assault speed just for the sheer fact that it can run mask. So if you're looking for that oddity to have in your mech set, then you can run it like this, and I'm going to show this to you real quick. But there are also videos on this mech, of course, on the channel. There we have him, the Skokomish. And if you look at the speed of this thing, 86 kph plus the mask on top of it. Yeah, this thing goes as fast as medium to lower speed light mechs, and you can do a lot of crazy stuff with it. But of course, you won't have the insane firepower that you would normally expect from an assault mech because you're running an XL395 engine, right? So, I think that concludes my recommendations for Inner Sphere Hero Mechs to buy. And if you're interested how to best play these mechs and how to best equip these mechs, then I recommend you use the search function on my YouTube channel. Just go directly to my YouTube channel, youtube.com/c/ttbprime. Click on that little search icon up there and just type in the name of the mech, for example, Cyclops or Sleipnir, and it's going to show you the builds that I did for this mech in particular. That is the simplest way that you can get the recommended builds for these kinds of mechs. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'm going to do the clan max next. Which clan max is TTB going to recommend? We shall see. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon.